Today in this class, I will explain about Mendel's monohybrid cross. What is monohybrid cross? Monohybrid cross means when a cross made between two plants which differ in a pair of characters. That is monohybrid cross. In this monohybrid cross, Mendel selected two plants as parents, and those two plants are tall plant and another one dwarf plant as parents. Tall plant consists of capital T and capital T as its genotype, and the dwarf plant consists of small t and small t as its genotype, right? So these are now parents, P for parents. When a cross made between these two plants, then gametes will be produced first, right? Actually, these plants are diploid in nature and gametes are haploid. At the time of gametogenesis, that is gamete formation, meiosis takes place, which results in the formation of haploid gametes. So from these plants, we can see gametes are like this. Capital T is a gamete which is released from tall plant and a small t from dwarf plant. So these are gametes, G for gametes. And the fusion of two gametes, capital T and small t, which results in the formation of capital T and small t plant, that is tall in nature. It is tall in nature, and this plant is called as F1 plant. F1 means filial, first generation. Okay, and he conducted self-pollination in F1 plant. So during self-pollination, this plant will give both male and female gametes. And the male and female gametes, we'll see which type of male and female gametes will be produced from the F1 plant, right? And in this F1 plant, so we'll write like self-pollination here. Self-pollination. Because of self-pollination, we will get F2 generation also. So here, these are the gametes, capital T and small t. Again, capital T and small t. These are the gametes. And these gametes are just to consider as male gametes. And these are female gametes. Female gametes. Right? Let us see the next step by using Punnett square or checkerboard. So here, this is Punnett square. In this Punnett square, we are taking both the gametes, male and female gametes, at both the sides. Right? For example, here capital T and small t, and here also capital T and small t. Just you consider one side is male gametes and another side is female gametes, right? Now when gametes are fused together, capital T here, and here capital T, small t, and here capital T, small t, and in the last box, small t, right? This is F2 generation, F2, filial 2 generation. In this F2 generation, if you observe carefully, in these four plants, the first one, this is tall plant, and second one also tall plant, and third one tall plant, and fourth one is dwarf plant, right? So phenotypically, when you observe externally these plants, four in these four, three are tall and one is dwarf. Otherwise, if you take in the sense of percentage, that is 75% of plants are tall plants, whereas 25% of plants are dwarf plants, right? Otherwise, in the sense of ratio, that is 3:1. 3 means tall, 1 is dwarf. So this ratio is called as phenotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio. right? Now let us do it something differently. Like in these four combinations of plants, the first one here, if you observe the genotype of this plant, both are capital T and capital T. Only one combination is there, right? That so here one capital T is one in ratio, and capital T and small t. Here one and another one is there, capital T small t, right? So capital T small t, those are two in ratio, and small t only one, right? So here small t that is one in ratio, one, one is to two is to one. So this is called as genotype or genotypic ratio. Genotypic ratio, right? So phenotypic ratio of monohybrid cross is 3:1, and genotypic ratio of monohybrid cross is 1:2:1, right? And after the completion of this monohybrid cross, he proposed two laws of inheritance, right? And the two laws of inheritance is the first law is law of dominance. Law of dominance. According to law of dominance, what it states means, in the case of this heterozygous condition, capital T and small t is recessive, capital T is dominant, right? So it dominates on small t. That's why small t character will not express it. That's why this plant is tall plant only. It is tall only. Okay, that is law of dominance, right? And the second law, that is called as law of segregation. Law of segregation. According to law of segregation, alleles which are there in parents, they are here fused together, but at the time of gametes formation they segregate independently, right? For example, see, capital T small t is the genotype of the parent, right? In this parent, whenever gametes are forming, these two alleles are getting separated and they are entering into different gametes, capital T and small t. They just separated. That is the meaning of law of segregation. So these are the two laws which are proposed by Mendel after the completion of monohybrid experiment on pea plant, right? Thank you.